Welcome! The object of today's class is plate tectonics, a powerful theory which allows us to explain and predict a large number of phenomena taking place in the Earth. The similarity of the shapes of South America and Africa across the Atlantic has struck the imagination of scientists since centuries, and is a clear demonstration that parts of the Earth thousands of kilometers across can easily move around the Earth. You're all familiar with the GPS, the Global Positioning System. Communicating with a network of stationary satellites, the GPS allows you to know where you are and to measure distances between points. Since the moment it started being used at a massive scale, we have now GPS stations spread all over the world, providing a huge amount of data, constraining with an error bar of less than a few centimeters the horizontal and vertical position of points across the Earth. This map shows you the displacement per year experienced by specific points with respect to an absolute system of reference. On the map, you can find domains where displacement vectors have similar orientation and magnitude, suggesting that these points lie on a rigid plate. This is the case, for instance, of the Pacific domain. If you move towards the west into the Australia region, you see that displacement vectors are very different. The Earth is then subdivided in rigid regions with little movement between one point and the other, separated by narrow domains across which vectors are very different. On the base of GPS movements, we can subdivide the surface of the Earth in roughly 12 major domains with little relative movements, called tectonic plates. These are separated by narrow zones of strong relative movements, which act as boundaries between the plates. As we will see, the margins accommodate different types of movements. GPS describe very accurate movements at the Earth's surface during the last decades at most. But when did these movements start? Have these movements always been going on? And since when? Studying, among others, rocks and fossils, geologists provide an answer. Geologists have discovered, for instance, that very similar fossils can be found in South America and Africa. This is obviously incompatible with the presence of a large ocean between the two continents. Very provocative ideas have been proposed, such as that of 1,000-kilometer-long bridges connecting the two continents. These fossils are 300 million years old and show that at that time the continents must have been together. Once scientists learned how to bring the continents back to their original position, a lot of more peculiar phenomena started making sense. Rock bodies with strong similarities presently outcropping on the two sides of the ocean turned out to belong to the same zone. Towards the beginning of the 20th century, it became accepted that continents had moved, and in the 60s, the theory of plate tectonics was formalized. Scientists presently agree that the outer part of the Earth is fragmented in a limited number of wandering major plates and that similar processes have been going on during the last 600 million years. 300 million years ago, for instance, the plates were all together, forming the mega continent Pangaea. Note that plate movements have changed during all this time. As a consequence, the number of plates has changed through time, and the nature of margins has also changed through time. What are these plates? To provide an answer to this question, we go back to what we've learned on the structure of the outer part of the Earth. Which one is the rigid part? And which are the layers and rocks on which the rigid part move? Let us start from the surface and we move downward. The crust on which GPS measurements are taken is underlain by mantle rocks, separated by the Moho discontinuity. Rocks above and below the Moho are solid and are well coupled to each other, thereby ruling out the possibility of relative movements between each other. We need to go deeper. At higher depths, the rigid and strong rock of the lithospheric mantle passed downward to the low velocity zone, where rocks have a small percentage of melt. These rocks are softer than the surrounding and form the soft substratum on which lithospheric plates move. The plates of plate tectonic theory are therefore lithospheric plates.